लंड काउंसिल फॉर द डिस्ट्रिक्ट कंपरेटिव बैंक्स हाउएवर सबमिटेड दैट द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया मस्ट एश्योर दैट द एंटायर अमाउंट ऑफर्ड बाय द डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स फॉर एक्सचेंज आफ्टर ड्यू वेरिफिकेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिमोनेटाइज्ड नोट्स विल बी ड्यूली रिप्लेस्ड बाय कमेंसरेट अमाउंट ऑफ लीगल टेंडर नोट्स Contemporarily, the London Attorney General on instruction submitted that the policy of replacement of legal tender notes as applicable to public sector banks and other banks will be applied even in the case of district cooperative banks for exchange of demonetized currency with the legal tender currency. We accept the assurance given by the London Attorney General in this behalf. The other broad point was about extending the time limit for exemption for use of demonetized currency notes of rupees 500 and rupees 1000 at specified counters as per the relevant notifications issued in that behalf by the Reserve Bank of India. It was contended that the exemption period provided in the concerned notification is expiring. Hence, it will not be possible to deposit the demonetized notes at specified counters thereafter, even in case of emergency situation like hospitalization, travel by railway or air, etc. In our opinion, whether the exemption period should be extended or not must be best left to the judgment of the government of the day, with a hope that the government will be responsive and sensitive to the problems of emergency by the common man. Accordingly, we decline to issue any interim direction to the government in the matter of extending the period of exemption and leave it open to the government to take appropriate decision in that behalf as may be advised. The other serious grievance made by the petitioners is about the denial of right to withdraw the prescribed amount of rupees 24,000 per week per account holder in spite of notification issued by the Reserve Bank of India permitting such withdrawal. It was submitted that if the government has issued such notification, after due consideration, it is obliged to ensure that its commitment made under the said notification is implemented without any exemption. The ground reality, however, contends Land Council is that the banks are refusing to pay full amount of rupees 24,000 per account holder per week on the ground of non-availability of enough volume of legal tender currency. According to the Land Attorney General, the government has already made it amply clear that it would take around 50 days time to streamline the cash flow. That period is still not exhausted. He submits that as of now, the Reserve Bank of India has been able to infuse around rupees 5 lakh of the new legal tender notes in the form of rupees 500 and 2000. That is almost over 40% of the amount of demonetized notes already deposited with the banks. Further, the authorities are working to the best of their ability to diffuse the crisis of cash flow situation by printing new notes.